have a little scholar who will give a talk on towards the understanding the Quran. Let's guess which scholar it is.
نحمده ونصلي على رسول الكريم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد. My respected elders and my dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you with the Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The topic of my talk is towards understanding the Quran. Subhanallah, with all the CDs, the tapes, the different size of the Quran, the translated Quran, this is nice and beautiful. But more of that is being devoted to preserving on the letters of the Quran, not very desperate on the commands of the Quran. What we want is to only learn how to read the Quran properly. It is good, but it seems pretty we always talk. I would like to recite a beautiful verse of the glorious Quran from Surah Al-Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 9. Inna hazal Qur'ana yahdi lillati aqwa, which means, indeed, this Quran guides humanity with that which is best. Best in form, best in manner, best in result, best in path. Keeping this in mind, my dear brothers and sisters, let's focus on some of the most valuable lessons of the Quran, which will guide us to make the best of people in the best of societies, inshallah. Among the very first words revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we all know that it was Iqra. What was the very next surah revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Surah Al-Muddassir. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was returning from the cave of Hira, Angel Jibril came to him and standing the horizon, he ran back, shivering to his wife Khadija radhiyallahu anha, covering with a piece of the cloth because he was very scared. The Allah spoke to him and revealed to him Surah Al-Muddassir, chapter number 74, verse number 1-5. Ya ayyuhal Muddassir, oh, the one wrapped up, come for Azir, rise and born. By the time Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was depriving himself from sleep, and then Khadija radhiyallahu anha used to come and say, Ya Muhammad, Ya Abdul Qazim, go to sleep. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say the time for sleep has long gone. Now I am involved and known as a rebellion, and that is number one. Number two, وَرَبُّكَ فَقَبِّرْ, and your Lord is glorified. The one who deserves to be glorified is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and only Allah's name has right to commit the place of the takbir. Nowadays, the movie star had become the great idol for the people. People want to dress like them. People want to talk like them. People want to be like them. People want to know what do they eat and what do they drink. People seem to glorify them. But in Islam, we are talking Allahu Akbar. Of all that is glorified, that Allah is the greatest. And Allah says, Wasiya baka fatahir, and cleanse, clean, purify your heart. And this was one of the mission of the Quran. And most of the time, we miss this point. We are expected to have a clear heart, a soft heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Varrudza fajur, put all your sins, all act of wickedness away from yourself. You cannot be a part of an evil and a molarity. A Muslim cannot and should not be a part of it. And these four commands given to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you really wanted to be benefited from the Quran, you have to remember the Quran in your lives. Aisha radhiyallahu anha was one as the character of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She answered that the character of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the living Quran. Subhanallah, it is so interesting that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the living Quran. I would like to end my talk with a hadith from Sahih al-Bukhari. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, khiyarukum man taqala al-Quran wal ma'u ghayri. The best amongst you is the one who learns the Quran and impart knowledge to others. May Allah make us from those who not only recite the Quran, but also implement the Quran into their lives. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.